Keeping the family fed and happy every day can be a thankless task. I want to put the excitement back into mealtimes, particularly for the cook. Smell that. Oh, my word. This is cooking.
So I've come up with a range of mouth-watering dishes that will free you from being tied to the stove.
Into the oven, job done. Recipes that are easy to make, delicious to eat, and add a bit of adventure to mealtimes.
I've even lined up some families to road test them.
To help change their mealtimes for good.
Does it even need cooking?
Yeah.
It smells so good.
From freezing to use another day, transforming leftovers and other tips to save time and money.
It's a frozen piece of haddock, comes out the bag, defrost it, you're not wasting anything at all.
Yeah.
My dishes will make kitchen life a pleasure without taking an age.
Oh, yeah. I knew you were good, but I didn't know you were that good.
Today, there's a spicy dish done two ways, plus a super-fast leftover lunch, two sweet store cupboard specials, and a dinner-time showstopper that could become the family favourite.
We all hate wasting food, and waste mainly comes from bad planning. We regularly buy too much without really thinking about how we're going to use it.
Meet the Blair family.
Hi, my name's Aurelia. I live in Upford with my three gorgeous kids and my lovely husband.
There's a lot of fun in this house, except for one thing. Mum Aurelia finds it impossible to make meals that everyone will like.
I will go to the supermarket and I'll get there and I'm thinking, what am I going to make now? And I might suggest something to kids. Oh, shall I make, you know, veggie bolognese? Ah, I don't want that. We had that last week, you know. And then, so I get there and I'm thinking, what shall I get?
The men of the family, Dad Nicholas and 10-year-old Xavier, like meat. 9-year-old Talia is a pescatarian. And 5-year-old Sienna changes her mind from day to day.
She's a joyful little girl, but she can be quite cheeky.
Everyone liking different things means a lot of food goes to waste.
Leftovers from chicken or ribs or anything really, yeah, Nicholas will bag it up and put it out for the foxes. I'm not sure how the neighbours feel about that, but yeah.
Why are you lot such bad planners then?
Just because everyone likes different things and it's just annoying. It just frustrates me and then I can't be bothered.
So how do you shop?
If I'm in a good mood, I'll have a list and I'll be like, right, I'm going to go, I'm going to get this and I'm going to do that. If I'm in a bad mood, I'll probably sit in the car park and cry for a little bit and then I'll come out and then I'll go, I don't know what I'm getting, I'm going. And that's what will happen. I'm not doing it.
There needs to be flexibility. Let's try and get a base dish that you can then say, right, OK, well, bit of that, we'll have a bit of that, we'll have a bit of that.
Yeah.
I hope to fix Aurelia's planning problems with clever dishes, using base ingredients easily combined with fish or meat to suit her family's different tastes. Yeah.